I'm Iain. I came out here in the middle of a freezing rainstorm because I was going to clean up this workbench, and as you can tell, that didn't really happen. What happened instead is I got distracted with this torch. Now, this is the torch, if you saw my video making the Yankee Candle stand, that I used. And this is the torch body that I use the most. It is a Victor clone, well, it's a clone of a Victor 100 series torch body. And it works really well. You can get Victor 100 series components super cheap all over the place. It's just a really good torch for general purpose use. The problem is that sometimes it's just a little too long to get in cramped places that I seem to find myself welding in for unknown reasons. So, I decided it would be fun to try and chop one of these things down, and I made a mini torch body that is half the length of the standard Victor torch body. Now, I don't recommend that you try this at home, because the torch body has the important job of keeping the gases separate. They don't mix until they get up into the tip. In here, they have to stay separate. You can't have a gas leak in there where they mix, because if they mix, you can get a flashback into the torch body, and that would be really bad for everybody involved. So, I don't recommend you do this. Why did I make this video? Mainly to document what I did to do this, and so you can get a better idea of how a torch body works and what's inside it. Because, believe it or not, I learned something new. What was in here was not what I was expecting at all. So, the important question is, does this mini torch work? And the answer is yes, quite well. It does everything the normal Victor 100 series does. It takes all the standard tips. You can even put the cutting head on it. It does everything that the standard Victor torch does, just half the length. So, let's get started chopping a perfectly good torch down into a mini torch. So in order to make a custom torch, I had to first get a standard torch that I could customize. So I went on eBay and I bought a Victor compatible torch. And this is a Victor 100 series body torch. And when you see Victor compatible, Harris compatible, Smith compatible, whatever compatible, it means that it is a copy of it, that they just basically figured out how to make it fit the parts, and they just crank out thousands of cheaper versions of it. So, that's what this is. And I've used different copies of the Victor 100 body, and I also have an authentic Victor 100 series torch. I've never had a problem with any of them, so I have high hopes that this one will be fine, and it should be, because really, when you think about it, a torch body is just a big chunk of brass. As long as the threading is done correctly, and the valve seats seat, it's going to be good to go. So, I have no issues with saving a little bit of money and getting the cheap knockoff, especially when we run the risk of totally screwing this thing up by modifying it. So, that's the torch. Let's start modifying it. So, the torch body is essentially made up of three things if we ignore the valves. We've got this big brass chunk down at the end. We've got this fluted extruded section that is the handle. And then we have this brass chunk at this end that has the threads for actually attaching the torch tip. We want to separate it right here. And you'll never be able to see it on camera, I don't think, but in real life, you can see an ever so slight seam right here. So I think they just knock off these flutes and are left with the round brass extrusion of the handle. It has a socket on this part, and I think they just solder it all together. So we're going to try and heat this up and unsolder it so we can move it down here. So I need to be able to hold this thing in the vise. The issue is, I don't want to screw up these threads, because if I can't put the welding tip on here ever again, this whole thing is for naught. So what I need to do is find a way to protect these threads in the vise. To do that, what I'm going to do is take this nut off of this tip. Now, any Victor tip that fits a 100 series torch, all you have to do is grab it and push up on it. There's a little snap ring that goes in the groove, and that'll pop out. And this is also how you change these O-rings. If the O-rings dry out and you need to replace them, you can just slide this nut off. You can also get just replacement nuts if something gets screwed up on it. In this case, I'm going to take it and thread it on. Now, I only want to use the nut, not the rest of it, because I don't want to melt the O-rings on it, and I don't want the heat to somehow affect the taper of this thing. So I just need that on here so that way I can put it in the vise and not risk screwing up the threads. Now, for the fun part. What I'm going to try and do is heat this thing up right here to melt the solder that I think is in there. I know the old Victor 100C bodies, the real old ones, are soldered together. So I'm assuming this Victor clone is also soldered together. But we will find out. If it's not soldered together, probably going to toast this thing. But we will give it a shot and see what happens. So I got the camera at a little bit of an angle, so hopefully I can get in here without messing up the camera. But if the camera moves a little bit, I apologize. And yes, I am using a torch to modify a torch. Oh, the irony. Which came first, the torch or the torch? And in that case, how did they make the first oxyacetylene torch if you need an oxyacetylene torch in order to make it? So it's constructed a little differently than I was expecting. I was expecting this thing to be soldered on, just soldered on like that. I was not expecting threads. Also, I was not expecting the tube within a tube design. I was expecting to have a hole down the center of a big brass chunk with maybe a couple other holes that ran parallel to it, because the thing is, the oxygen and acetylene don't mix in the handle. They stay separate up until the tip. That's why there's two O-rings. That's why there are two different sets of holes. You've got one hole on the outside, one hole on the inside. So the gas stays separate right until it gets to this point right here. Then it starts mixing all the way along the tube up to the tip. It doesn't mix in here. You want it to be separate here. And the reason you want it to be separate right here is the separate gases don't burn. You don't want them mixing before they're supposed to mix, because if it was to flash back, it could flash back into here, and that would be really bad, and that would wreck your day pretty fast. So what we need to do is take this end off and get even more creative with cutting both of these sections down, and I'm going to have to take a chunk out of the middle and braze the two halves back together in order to get threads on each end, and that taper has to be on each end of the tube. So it's going to be a little more tricky than I thought, but I think we can probably still pull it off. This one's going to be a little easier to disassemble because I can hold it in the vise without any fear of messing up delicate threads. And now that I know it doesn't have to unsolder, I just have to heat up the sealant a little bit. It's probably some form of gas safe, oxygen safe, Loctite or something. I just have to heat it up and twist it off. There we go. Okay. So, the outer tube threaded at both ends. That makes up the handle. We're going to have to cut a chunk out of the middle, braze it back together. I think I can handle that. The inside. Ooh, is even more interesting. Because I don't think you can see on the camera what I can see in person, but what I'm looking at down in the base of the torch is a threaded connection for this center tube. So that's going to be staying just like that. I'm not going to mess with the threaded connection. Yes, I am. I'm messing with it. Okay. This is one of those make it up as you go along type projects. So I've decided to mess with the threaded connection. Because I'm hoping I will be able to find a die to re-thread it afterwards. Now, to get the threaded connection off, because I'm assuming that has more of the sealant down there, I'm probably going to have to heat that up. There we go. Yes, so that is a threaded connection right there. And that's good because it has straight threads on it. They don't have any kind of taper to them. And that makes my life a little easier because I don't have to be quite as precise in cutting this inner tube down the exact same amount as this tube. I have to be as close as I can, but I don't have to be quite as precise because this gives me a little bit of fine tuning because I need this to be a precise fit in that taper, so that way it doesn't leak and mix the gases where the gases aren't supposed to mix. This will let me screw it in or unscrew it a little bit to get it just right, so I'm happy about that. Now I've got to cut a chunk of this out of the middle in order to shorten this whole torch down. So the best thing to do that with is the horizontal bandsaw. So there's one threaded end. I want to cut the tapered end of the inner tube off before I cut the outer tube, because I want to be able to set up a stop block and not move it in between cuts, so that way they're the exact same amount removed. It'll make a little more sense when you see me do it. I want to put the vise grips on this because I have a feeling this little piece is going to go down in the chip tray, and I don't want to find it in the chip tray. That's a lot easier than trying to hunt for it down in a big pile of cutoffs. I changed the camera angle just so that way you could see what I'm doing, because this is a little tricky. The problem is there's not enough left in the vise to be able to really hang on to this thing all that well. And more importantly, what's in there is past the pivot point right here. So if I just clamp this thing in, it would push. This side of the jaw would pivot in towards the fence, and I would never be able to hang on to this thing real well because it would just squash that side in. It would make it tapered and try and force it out. So what I have is a bolt with another bolt acting as a handle that I can adjust to take up that space. It's an adjustable spacer block. You can get little screw-out blocks for machining, but this is the cheaper alternative. That way, when I tighten it up, it has something on both sides of that bolt in order to keep it parallel, and it'll hang on to this. There's another issue. The blade cuts over here, and there's not much in the vise. So it would want to rotate that thing out. It would break the blade, wreck the torch body, everybody would be sad. So what I did is I took a scrap piece of keystock and clamped it on to keep this end of it from twisting that way. It acts as a little fence on this side of the cut so it can't twist. Finally, I clamped a chunk of aluminum right here to act as a stop block so that way I can take the exact same amount out of this and the centerpiece, because it's key that they stay the same length in relationship to each other. So let's try cutting it. Perfect. The inner tube happens the exact same way. I just back this bolt out a little bit so that way the jaws stay parallel again. And again, with the stop block, I'm guaranteed to remove the same amount of material out of both pieces so they stay the same length in relation to each other, because that's key to getting it to be gas tight. I've decided for testing purposes to just solder this thing together with some good old-fashioned 60-40 leaded solder. And some people might have issue with it having a lower melting temperature than the brass, but honestly, hoses have a melting temperature even less than the solder. So I have a feeling in the case of total torch annihilation, something will give before the solder joint does. So I just clamp it together. You saw me put some regular old acid flux for soldering pipe together just to clean it as best as possible because we want a good solder connection that is leak proof. And now we just solder it together. What I'm looking for is for capillary action to pull the solder down into the joint. I'm not trying to build up a big fillet on the outside. It should be in between the two pieces. And what I'll do is I'll let it cool down a little bit. I'll rotate in the vise and do it again to make sure I get solder all throughout the thing. Because again, it's got to be gas tight. Now I'm just using the vise as kind of a V-block to hold the center tube in alignment, and I've put flux on the edges again. Now I'll just solder this together. I'm ready to start reassembling this thing. I've got the inner tube and the outer tube soldered back together and cleaned. I wanted to clean them really well with acetone. I buffed this with the wire wheel on the bench grinder a little bit just to remove some of the discoloration from soldering. But you want to clean them out really well because if any oil got in there, which I was very careful not to put oil on anything, but just to be safe, oil in the presence of pure oxygen spontaneously combusts, and it combusts very violently. So I want to be careful that there's no oil in this thing when I put it back together. I put some pipe dope on these threads in the inner tube, and I'm just going to thread it onto the base and snug it down. They're straight threads, so really doesn't have to be more than snug. Because, again, this is also how we're going to adjust the length of this thing. Now, I can go ahead and put the inner tube on.